exhibit came about because Landmarks wanted to use our new space here at Architecture St. Louis to celebrate Black History Month. The social greatness of the street really begins with the Robbins family in 1943 buying their home and piercing through the veil of restrictive covenants, which leads not only to the reversal of decades of St. Louis real estate policy, but also to a deep-seated and deep-rooted and enduring pride for that street and among its residents. Without further ado, I'm going to introduce Pamela Talley, who is keeping the flame alive as president of Lewis Place Historical Preservation.
I'd like to thank everybody for coming out this evening. My board persons, Gwen Moore, who is also a historian, and has been very, very helpful. She has done a number of the oral histories throughout the neighborhood. Dr. Malika Horn, who's her sister, and Isaiah, and just so many people. Isaiah Hare, who has been a partner as we've traveled this road and tried to fight blight and the divestment in communities throughout North St. Louis. One of my dear neighbors throughout the neighborhood, she lives on Evans, Tammy Tate. And certainly Mr. Curtis. I just have to acknowledge these people because they have just always been there for me. The journey is just quite interesting and exciting. We wish we could get the city on board as much as we have other organizations coming forth. Okay. All right. Thank you all very much.
My name is Tammy Tate, and I live on Evans Avenue, Evans and Taylor. I love it. I just love it there. The dogs, the cats, and my kids, we love it.
The first family to actually purchase a house on the block, the Robbins family, down at 4740. It happened, and it was about 2.5 years before they actually got possession of the house. You know, they had what was called the Finney District, which was the black code for the black community. So as the community just, of course, after the war and the migration from the south to the north, the black community just needed to spread out. And the community that had the most affluence and financial wherewithal were the professional black folks, who basically were the ones who waged the struggle to get into the entire neighborhood. You know, we have homes that were built in the 1890s. A lot of the bigger homes and the ones that are kind of like the mini mansions, I guess. Number 8, which was the old Lewis, the developer's home. This home, I think, is number 14. Again, one of the mini mansions, but you have a lot of smaller bungalows that was built in 1914 to 1916, and at the same time there was this huge arts and craft movement going on, right? So you can begin to see some of the details. I am just so heartbroken by the fact that the city fathers have made a decision to divest in this part of the community. And I mean, that's everything north of Delmore. And I think if people all over the city knew what happened to North St. Louis systematically, I think that they would just be outraged at policies that would just kill a city.
Richard Robbins, and my grandparents were the first black family to move into Lewis Place in 1945.